We'll show you in this tutorial how to set up your ThinPrint Hub in just a few simple steps. Each box includes a ThinPrint Hub, a plug, and 4 adapter plugs. Insert the micro USB plug from the supplied power adapter with the USB icon facing down into the ThinPrint Hub. Connect all other necessary cables with the hub to connect it then to the printer. If these are network printers, connect the hub using a network cable. If USB printers are to be made available for your employees, plug each USB cable into one of the 4 available slots. Plug the power supply into the outlet. Then, the red LED on the front of the hub will light up. It's now ready to set up. Now, go to a PC to use the ThinPrint Hub Finder to locate the device in your network. Download the Hub Finder from our download page. Just click on the info card in the top right. You can also find the link below in the video description. Once the Hub Finder is open, click on Start Search. Then you'll see how the hub appears in the Finder. If you have multiple hubs, you can see which hub is which by clicking on Identify. Next, click on the URL. The Hub Configuration page then opens in your browser. Accept the certificate here, and you can replace it later on with one from your own company. Use the web console to upload it to the hub as a web server certificate. Here below, you can find other useful links, such as the hub manual. Log in to the web console. If the login password is not set, then use the default password, which is print for life. Here is the web console. In the upper right corner, you can choose the language. Now, to add your printer, click on the printer menu item and then on Add Printer. Specify for each destination network printer a printer name and its address, and optionally, the driver name. Confirm the settings by clicking on Save. It's easy to add a USB printer. Just select USB in the drop-down menu. If the printer is already connected, it's recognized right away. And if you want, select a default printer. This is where all print jobs are sent, for which none or an incorrect printer ID is configured on the server side. So that's all there is to it. The ThinPrint Hub is now ready for printing with ThinPrint.